have some time to look at questions 25 to 30. Now listen and answer questions 25 to 30.
So why don't you quickly go through the main sections of your presentation and discuss what actions needed for each part?
Okay. So for the introduction, we're using a visual. So once we've prepared that, we're done.
I'm not sure. I think we need to write down all the ideas we want to include here. Not just rely on memory. How we begin the presentation is so important.
You're right.
The discovery of the mammoth tooth is probably the most dramatic part, but we don't have that much information, only what we got from the online article. I thought maybe we could get in touch with the researcher who led the team and ask him to tell us a bit more.
Great idea. What about the section with the initial questions asked by the researchers? We've got a lot on that, but we need to make it interesting.
We could ask the audience to suggest some questions about it, and then see how many of them we can answer. I don't think it would take too long.
Yes, that would add a bit of variety.
Then the section on further research carried out on the island, analysing the mud in the lake. I wonder if we've actually got too much information here. Should we cut some?
I don't think so, but it's all a bit muddled at present.
Yes, maybe it would be better if it followed a chronological pattern.
I think so. The findings and possible explanations section is just about ready, but we need to practice it so we're sure it won't overrun.
I think it should be okay, but yes, let's make sure.
In the last section, relevance to the present day, you've got some good ideas, but this is where you need to move away from the ideas of others and give your own viewpoint.
Okay, we'll think about that. Now, shall we show you some of the...